This week on 20 TV Insider, we'll take you to the biggest musical festival in District 20. Also, we'll head up to Cheyenne Mountain Zoo for the Electric Safari. Plus, the Liberty Boys basketball team looks to replace a big senior class. The Classical Academy takes on an old rival in boys basketball. You're watching 20 TV Insider from Academy District 20 in Colorado Springs, Colorado.
Hello and welcome to 20 TV Insider, your weekly look into events in Academy School District 20. I'm Brian German. Thanks for joining us today. Craft lovers from around the Springs flock to Rampart High School for the annual Craft Bazaar. The Rampart Craft Bazaar serves as a fundraiser for the school, as well as clubs and organizations within Rampart. The bazaar is popular among the public because all of the crafts are entirely handmade, and many come searching for unique gifts to give during the holidays.
The craft fair is important to Rampart High School as it's our only fundraiser of the year that the parent group does, and it funds things such as our after prom and our teacher appreciation lunch, but then it also funds all of our teacher grant requests that come in from athletics and academics.
To get involved, vendors must apply online and have a handcrafted item to show to get approved and placed in the bazaar. A special event each year features talented students from most of the District 20 schools. The D20 Choir Festival was held in late November at the Pikes Peak Center in downtown Colorado Springs. All of the middle and high schools in District 20 were represented, including an elementary honor choir. Students performed in front of a large audience and had the opportunity to see other schools perform. Many different styles of music were sung, including musical numbers, classical, and foreign. Paula Bach, the choral director at Air Academy High School, says leading such a large group is a great opportunity.
Making music is really something that's an incredible experience, not only producing the singing by doing it yourself as the human voice, but I found that being a director is a great deal of fun.
As a final performance, all of the choirs got together to sing a piece from Les Miserables. Students at Liberty High School are enjoying the performing arts side of education. Liberty's dance program has been offered for 7 years under Leslie Williams' direction. The dance program offers classes ranging from beginner to advanced. All dance classes are about an introduction to all types of dance styles. Now, the dance program has around 140 students each semester. Williams teaches ballet, modern, and jazz techniques, as well as how to perform. By the end of the class, students should have a greater understanding of performing arts.
There's one person who excels the most in class, and that's the type of person that's willing to put in the work every single day. So whether they're the best dancer or the strongest dancer, if someone comes into class every single day wanting to do their best and wanting to learn and wanting to improve, they're going to do really well in my dance classes.
Liberty High School recently held their fall semester dance performance on December 12th. Well, every winter in the southwest part of the Springs, a part of Cheyenne Mountain lights up for the holidays. As 20 TV student Nicole Vogt shows us, the Cheyenne Mountain Zoo's Electric Safari is a one-of-a-kind show.
Every year, Cheyenne Mountain Zoo staff holds their holiday-themed Electric Safari. During this time of year, the zoo lights up their animal exhibits with over a million sparkling lights and animal-themed sculptures. Cheyenne Mountain Zoo started preparation for this event in early October. Since then, the zoo has worked hard hanging lights and preparing animals for their opening night. The zoo's staff saw their hard work pay off when they reached an attendance of over 1,000 people on their first night. Jenny Hillard, the marketing director at Cheyenne Mountain Zoo, explains some popular attractions at the Electric Safari.
The best part about Electric Safari is you get the zoo experience, but you also get to get in the holiday spirit. So we have all the lights going on. You can walk around and just hear the Christmas music and the holiday music and really get into the spirit of the holidays.
The guests that attend the Cheyenne Mountain Zoo during this time of the year have the opportunity to participate in many activities. Some of the guests' favorite activities include watching animal demonstrations and meeting Santa Claus. Staff provides spots around the zoo for guests to warm up at, such as warming fires and indoor exhibits. The attendance is important to the zoo this time of year because the Electric Safari is one of Cheyenne Mountain Zoo's top fundraisers.
We are a nonprofit organization and we use events like this to help keep the zoo running.
Guests have been enjoying attending the event so far this year, and attendance in the Electric Safari is predicted to grow as it gets closer to Christmas.
Electric Safari is open 23 nights this season, including the rest of December, except for Christmas Eve. Let's turn to sports, where the Classical Academy boys basketball team is hoping to find success in their first year of 4A competition, but they'll need to find more scoring if they want to play in the postseason. The Titans averaging just 43 points per game so far, and that won't translate into a lot of wins when they're giving up more than 47 points a game. They hosted rival Manitou Springs last week in a game we broadcast live on 20 TV. Once again, scoring struggles were the theme for the Titans. TCA put up just 14 points in the first half as their big man, Will Ball, was held in check for much of the game. Despite that, the Titans were down 3 late in the game, but eventually fell to the Mustangs by a final score of 42-37. They fall to 2-3 on the year. The Liberty High School boys basketball team has struggled early this season, losing 3 of their first 4 games. The Lancers have had difficulty putting up points after losing 70% of their scoring from last year. It took them a while to get started against Pueblo West last week. The Cyclones jumped out to an early lead, but Liberty would respond. The Lancers were led in scoring by junior Chris Gaines, who made 3 three-pointers. He finished with 11 points. After scoring just 20 points in the first half, Liberty added 39 more in the second, and they went on to win by a final score of 59-52. And remember, you can watch all of those District 20 teams this winter by tuning into our live broadcasts. This week, we'll be at Rampart High School on Tuesday, the 16th, for a boys basketball game against Coronado. Then on Thursday, the 18th, we head to Pine Creek, where the Eagle girls basketball team welcomes Fossil Ridge High School. Both broadcasts start at 7 p.m., and they can be viewed live on our website at asd20.org/20tvsports. You also can access all of our highlights and archived broadcasts at that website. Well, this is our last 20 TV Insider of 2014, but we will be back with more great District 20 news and sports on January 13th. Now, if you have some stories you'd like us to cover that would affect the District 20 community, please give us a call on our tip line. That's 719-234-1780, or send us an email to 20tv@asd20.org. Thanks for joining us. Merry Christmas, everyone, and have a great holiday season.
Oh! Checking your fantasy league?
Nah, just my 401k statement.
Nice. Where'd you find the money for that?
I've just been saving a little every month.
I can't seem to save anything.
Well, what about all this? What about the money you're spending?
What money? It's gone before I can get my hands on it.
I got a pizza for a Todd.
Hey, can somebody spot me?
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind.
It's 547.
Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org.